Hello, in this video we will learn Flexbox. We will start with the basic concepts and build up. If you are already familiar with the basics, you can skip to the section about shrink and grow. Let's start with the basics. To enable a flex layout, simply add the display flex property to the container elements. In a flex layout, there are two axes, the main axis and the cross axis. To change the direction of the main axis, you will use the flex direction property. You can set the main axis in four different ways. For left to right, row. This is the default behavior. For right to left, row reverse. For top to bottom, column. And for bottom to top, column reverse. To adjust how items align along the main axis, you use the justfify-content property. There are 6 options you can apply. Flex start aligns items to the start of the main axis. This is the default. Flex end pushes items to the end of the main axis. Center centers items along the main axis. Space between puts equal space between items. Space evenly distributes space evenly between items, start and end. And space around places equal space around items with 1x space on the start and end and 2x space between items. The justify content is responsible for the main axis. To control the cross axis, we use the align items property. There are 5 common options. The default is stretch, which makes items grow to fill the container's height, provided items don't have a height set. The second option is flex start. It aligns items to the start of the cross axis. Flex end aligns items to the end of the cross axis. Center centers items along the cross axis. Baseline aligns items so that their text baselines line up. When you set align items to baseline, you might not notice any difference at first. It can look just like flex start. But if you increase the font size of one item, you will see the effect. Baseline alignment ensures that the text in all items aligns perfectly at the bottom. In some cases, baseline is a better choice. Think of a header on a e-commerce website with a brand name and a few navigation links. If you use align items center, something might look off-center. By switching to baseline, the text aligns more naturally, even if the brand name isn't perfectly centered. What do you think? Which option is the best, center or baseline? Let me know in the comments. Until now, we had only 3 items and they fit just fine in our container. But what happens when we increase the number to 10? There are 2 questions to consider. Why all items in a single row even though we have space? And why each item's width is less than 200 even though I set it to that size?
Not after I specifically told you not to do that.
First, let's address the single row issue. This is where the flex wrap property comes in. By default, its value is no wrap, meaning all items will stay on the same row. When we change it to wrap, the items can move to the next line if there is no more space available in the current row. In wrap mode, you have multiple lines or main axes. To control these, you use the align content property. The default value is normal. Other values work similar to align items, but they control the entire container. For example, flex start will move all items to start, removing any excess space. Flex end will move all items to the end. Center will center all items. You can also use space between, space around, or space evenly as well. If you want the items to take up all the available space, don't give them a height property and use align content stretch. To give items some breathing room, you can use the gap property. You can even set different gaps for row and column if you have multiple lines. Now, this next section is crucial for truly understanding Flexbox. We will discuss flex grow, flex sharing, flex basis, and how items behave in different scenarios.
This is where the fun begins.
Earlier, when we set each item's width to 200 and increased the item count to 10, we saw the items shrunk. They were no longer 200 wide. In Flexbox, there are 2 types of size. The first is ideal size. This is the size you want, but it is not guaranteed. When I set an item's width to 200, I'm saying, oh mighty Flexbox algorithm, please make this item 200 pixel wide, if it is possible, of course. And the second size is minimum size. This is the smallest size the item can shrink to. The Flexbox algorithm will ensure that an item doesn't shrink beyond this minimum size. If I increase the item count to 50, you will notice 2 things. First, the items no longer fit in the row and overflow. And second, each item has a weird width based on its content. This is because the Flexbox algorithm determines a minimum size for each item, preventing it from shrinking further than its content allows. Now let's learn about the flex shrink property. This property tells the algorithm how much an item should shrink compared to others. If you add the value 2 to the first item, it will shrink twice as much as the other. If you give it a really high number, like a million, the algorithm will shrink that item first before others. Yes, actually others will shrink as well, but million times less. If you set flex shrink to 0, the item won't shrink at all and will maintain its ideal size. So where will you use flex shrink? Imagine a info box with a fixed width, an icon at 24 pixels, and some text. You have used align items to center them. If the text is short, everything is fine. But if the text is long, the icon starts shrinking, which is a common issue you might encounter. To fix this, simply add flex shrink 0 to the icon and it will maintain its ideal size. Now that we have covered flex shrink, let's move on to flex grow. It works similarly, but instead of shrinking, it controls how items grow. Let's say you have a sidebar, a content section, and table of contents. You want the content to fill any remaining space. To do that, add flex grow 1 to the content section. If there is excess space, this item will take it since no one else wants it. If another item also has flex grow, like the sidebar, a mini calculation will take place. Let's say that there are 300 pixels of excess space. The algorithm checks if any children have flex growth. In this case, yes, two of them. It adds their flex growth values, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Then it divides the excess space by the total. So 300 divided by 3 is 100 pixels. Then finally it multiplies each value by 100 pixels. So the sidebar gets 200 and the content gets 100. Okay, let's talk about flex spaces and finish our video. We know that the main and cross axes can change based on the flex direction property. With flex spaces, you can constantly target the main axis item size, whether it is in row or column direction. When the direction is row, flex spaces acts as the width property. When the direction is column, flex spaces acts as the height property. If both width and flex spaces are set, flex spaces takes precedence. The same goes for height in the column direction. If you set flex spaces to 0, it means the ideal size is the minimum size. However, if you add flex grow 1, the remaining space is divided between the items. To divide the container size into equal parts, you can use these two properties. There is also a shorthand for this called flex 1. With the flex property, you can set the grow, shrink, and basis values only in one line. When flex 1 is given, flex grow will be 1, flex shrink will be 0, and flex basis will be 0 as well. There is much to learn about flex layouts, but the best way to truly understand them is to practice.